and welcome to the Mortal Realms. This Warhammer Age of Sigmar introductory set is everything you need to start your journey into one of the amazing and exciting worlds of Warhammer. Don't be worried if this is your first time. I'll show you how to build your models, set up a painting area, and teach you the basics on how to get them from grey plastic to gloriously painted miniatures, ready for battle. So let's start by building our models together. In this set, you get a lot of models. And it might be overwhelming, but don't worry. I'll walk through all the steps. Building miniatures is therapeutic and rewarding, and is a big part of the Warhammer hobby. These models are what we call easy to build. They push off the sprue frame, push together, and require no glue or tools at all. So let's get what we need on our table. You get 5 Stormcast Eternal Liberators, armored warriors of the God King Sigmar, and their mighty hammers and shields. You also get 20 Skaven Clanrats, skittering and deadly creatures with different weapons, and one even has a banner. Now you know what you have, let's start building one of those Liberators. Looking at the handbook, there is a how to build section that has steps for each model in the set. As you can see, there are numbers associated with each piece on the sprue frame. These are the parts that we need to build this first model. Now we have found part one, you can see there is a small arrow on this piece of the sprue. If we gently push our thumb against that, the plastic will come loose from that connection point. Then we can carefully remove the piece from the rest of the sprue with a small amount of force. There you go, and now we can do the rest for the other pieces. Just click and gently push away from the sprue. With our 4 pieces ready, we can look back at the construction guide for this first Liberator to put it together. It's super important to follow the instructions, so all the pieces fit in order. By looking at this first box, we have to push part 1, the back, and part 2, the hammer arm, together. There are pegs that will pop into these holes, so they stay together as we build. Then we can do the same with part 3, the front, and part 4, the head. Then we should be at the stage where we can see both these halves with blue areas. The blue indicates there is a small step to complete before moving on. This is why it's super important to read the whole guide for the model before popping the pieces together. And now we can pop those 2 parts together, then add part 5 and 6 for the other arm and shield in the same way. Now the Liberator is ready to pop on its base. This Liberator fits on a 40mm round base. These bases have holes that the pegs of the foot can go into. So align both feet to stand on the base and then you can easily pop it on. You can see there are small pieces of scenery to fill the spare hole, so just pop that in the hole too. Well done, you just built your first miniature. Now you can keep going and use the same techniques to build the other 4 Liberators, following their guide. When it comes to the Skaven, it's the same story. These smaller models may have less pieces, but they have thinner parts, so be really careful when pushing them off the sprue. All the Skaven fit on the 25mm bases once you have built each model. Now you can see how much character these Clanrats have. The leader has this massive blade, and the musician has a little bell. Once you have all your models built and popped on their bases, you have the start of 2 fighting forces, ready to paint. But first, we need to set up our painting area. A simple but well set up painting area makes life so much easier, especially when it's your first time painting. Make sure you've got a hard, stable surface to paint on, just like the table we built our models on, and a covering for it to prevent any damage in the event of a paint spillage. Don't worry, we've all done it. Something like an old newspaper is really helpful. I've got this cutting mat to cover mine. It's also handy to have some paper towels to dry off your brush and clear up any of those little spills. You'll also need some clean water. An old jam jar or cup filled will do just fine. I'll be using a Citadel colour water pot for mine. Finally, we need something to use as a palette. An old plate or piece of cardboard will work just fine if you don't have a Citadel colour paint pad like I have here. Also, keep the handbook nearby. It has lots of tips and basics on painting too. We'll also need a good light to paint in. So if it's daytime, make sure you have a lot of natural light. So if you have a lamp, that will help you see all the details as you paint. Great, now we're set up, we are ready to paint our models together. Painting is a key part of the Warhammer hobby. Some hobbyists paint to make their battles feel more immersive. Others paint to unwind and relax, while some fans want to turn each of their models into a work of art. To get these models painted, I'll show you the basic techniques and steps to get these plain grey models to a bright and bold miniature ready to play with. So we'll start with the Stormcast Eternals. Before we start any painting, we'll learn one of the fundamentals: thinning your paints ready for application. This is the most important thing you need to know, no matter how new or experienced you are at the hobby. So we'll take our pot of Retributor Armour, our gold colour, and give it a good shake before opening. This makes sure that all the pigment is fully mixed, so we get a great colour all over once it's dried. Then we'll open the pot all the way till the tab clicks in place, holding our paint open ready for use. Now we'll take our starter brush in hand, making sure that we're comfortable with how we hold it. Sometimes like a pen, with your fingers just behind the metal tube, holding the bristles of the brush. Then we'll use our brush to scoop a little of the paint out of the small reservoir in the lid. Then we'll pop our paint on our palette of choice, making sure that we get most of it off the brush at this point, but keep it neat and all together in a small puddle. Now we can thin our paint down with a drop of water. Just dip the tip of the brush in the water pot, then mix it into the paint on the palette. Just take your time to gently mix it all together. Then you should notice the paint flows much smoother instantly. If not, just add a little bit more water. We don't want to add too much though, or it won't sit on a model. If you do thin it too much, then add a little bit more paint. If you apply too much paint, it will dry with a lumpy finish, and we don't want that. Then we'll quickly clean off our brush so it's neat and all the bristles will stay together for longer. That's why keeping paint out of that metal tube called the ferrule is important. Any dry paint in there will damage the brush. Drying your brush is also important too. This makes sure that you don't add any additional water into your mix. So use that paper towel every time you clean your brush. Amazing! Now your paint is ready to use. I'll teach you the first step in painting your models: undercoating. Your models need to be undercoated completely in one colour of paint before you can do any painting. It is a strong foundation that all the other colours will stick to and build up on to create some amazing looking models. To start undercoating, we'll load some of our thinned Retributor Armour onto our brush. When loading your brush, load the bristles no more than halfway, as it's seen here. Load up the brush with a small amount of paint from your palette each time. Then get your Liberator Prime model to undercoat. He's the leader with the plume on his helmet. Just hold him by the base. Comfortable with painting, with your elbows or wrists on the table, so you are stable when painting and you won't slip around. You can always move the model around too, getting into all the small gaps and under the shield. We'll apply one coat to the model fully, getting more thinned Retributor Armour from the palette when you start to run out. The first coat we'll apply will look patchy, and that's totally fine. We don't want to overload and lose any of those details on the model. Just go around the whole model, making sure that you get every section covered with paint. You may find that it's easier to start in the middle of the body and work outwards, or start from top to bottom. It's really up to you how you apply your undercoat. Now we have our first patchy coat applied, we need to leave it to dry, and cleaning off your brush between coats. This can take up to 10 minutes. So why not get a drink and have a read about what the Stormcast Eternals are on page 21. Now that first coat is dried, we can get some more thin paint on our brush and apply a second coat. You may notice this time around the paint is sticking to the model much better, filling in those patchy gaps, and now the gold is looking a lot shinier. Then we can leave it to dry again and repeat the process one more time. These three thin coats of paint will give us a solid, smooth and shiny undercoat for our Liberator. Now you can repeat this undercoating technique for the rest of your Stormcast Eternals. You can either do this one model at a time, or do a couple in a group. I'll be painting three of them in this guide. Some people find this is quicker, and some prefer not to. It's really up to you. Now you've learned undercoating, let's move on to learning about base coating and adding more colours. Base coating is very similar to undercoating, but you're adding a colour on top of an undercoat to add colour and show details. The first colour we'll be using for this is Leadbelcher, a great silver colour for our Liberators. For this step, we'll thin down our paint in the same way as the Retributor Armour for undercoating, as it's perfect for base coating too. Shake the pot and click it open, pop the paint on the palette and thin with water. With this colour, we'll focus on the scale mail skirt, painting the front and back. We'll also paint the hammerhead and spiked metal shaft connecting the hammer to the haft. With base coating, you'll need two coats to cover the undercoat with a solid finish. So apply the first coat to all the details, then allow time for it to dry. Then you can apply the second coat to get that shiny silver colour. Don't worry if you make a bit of a mess on the other areas right now. We'll all make a mess when painting is a part of the process. By having that undercoat applied, we have given this colour a great foundation to stick to, allowing our colours to be smooth and solid. So it's really worth the time to paint. You may have noticed that the paints we are using so far are called base on the pot. This is a type of citadel colour paint designed for thinning down and used for undercoating and base coating, as they have a lot of pigment that give us these solid coats. A good habit to learn after using metallic paints is changing your paint water so it's nice and clean. This makes sure that any paints you'll thin down next won't have these shiny bits mixed into them. We also advise this after using dark colours or any paints that are very vibrant. Now you have your Leadbelcher on and dry, we can apply another colour, just in the same way. Now we can add Kantor Blue to our Liberators, thin down on our palette. We'll use this colour for both shoulder pads, trying to avoid the gold trim on the top and the icons in the middle. You can use the tip of the brush to lightly get around those details. Then we'll also use this to paint the front of the shield, also avoiding the trim and icons. But don't worry, we can tidy up in a moment. We just want to make sure that we get those coats on with drying time between each one, creating a solid dark blue. Now we have a few colours down, we can tidy up any mistakes. You can tidy up at any time. Some people like to do it after every stage, but you do risk adding too much paint to a model. It's best to do it either after a few paints or right at the end of the base coating stage. To tidy up and fix mistakes, we just need to apply some thinned colour back over. For example, I got a bit of Kantor Blue on the trim of the shield, so I'll thin down some Retributor Armour and apply a small amount over the blue. It might only need one coat, but colours that are darker or much brighter may need a second coat. I'll tidy up the rest later once we're all done. Now our blue is dried and our mistakes corrected, you can see our mighty Liberators are coming to life. So let's keep going with a few more colours. Now you're getting the hang of base coating, we'll power through our last colours of our Liberator. Our next colour is Khorne Red, and for this we'll be using it on the Liberator Prime's helmet plume, the hammer handle, the dagger hilt, and any little gems found on the hammer head or shield fronts. These are very small details, so use the tip of the brush and we can tidy up any little smudges once dried. Remember to take your time. Painting is fun, and you will want to make sure that everything is as perfect as it can be. So not rushing your work will lead to better results. Amazing work! We've almost got our models done, so let's keep going. This next colour only covers a few details, but it's still super important. Rakarth Flesh is a light base coat colour that we'll be using for the scroll on the Liberator Prime's shield. As this is a lighter colour of paint, you may even find that you need three coats to cover the gold undercoat. And this is totally fine. Just make sure that they are smooth and fully dry before you apply the next coat. We'll also use this for any parchment and rocks found on the models. There is also one that has a skull on the base. If you want any help to see where these details could be, you can check out the gallery images on page 16 for the Stormcast Eternals. And now we can paint the last base coat on our Liberators. We'll be using Steel Legion Drab for the dagger scabbard and the belt around the back of the model. We just want to avoid the gold details on the ends of the scabbard and the dagger itself. If there's any dirt around the rocks, we can paint that too. Then we can also paint the shield strap around the arm and the front of the belt if you can. Seeing they are very small details and there is a lot of gold around them, you can always tidy back up once it's dried with Retributor Armour again. This is the best time to tidy up any of our colours, so tidy up those icons on the shield, the metal belt buckles and those tiny gems too. It's best to tidy up once you have all your base coats down in place, and tidying up all at once. But it's really up to you when you do this. Just remember to take your time, keep the paint in the tip of the brush, and you'll be done in no time at all. And don't worry if the base is a bit messy, we have an extra step towards the end of the video to fix that. And there we are! You just completed your first Stormcast Eternal Liberators. You should be really proud of what you've achieved just in 6 colours. You have mastered the basics of undercoating and base coating, enjoying the journey along the way. You can copy these steps over for the rest of your Liberators, so they can be ready for battle against the enemies of Sigmar. Talking about the enemies of Sigmar, we'll be looking at painting the Skaven next. And with what we have learnt from our Liberators, we'll have all the skills and knowledge that we need to make this a whole lot easier and quicker. For the Verminous Ratmen, I'll be painting the Claw Leader, Standard Bearer and Musician. But you can paint any amount in this sitting, it's really up to you. Remember, you have a lot of models, like 20 Clanrats to paint, so it's a lot easier if you break them up into smaller batches. 5 is a great number once you are happy with your paint scheme. Right, let's get started. The first thing we need to do is undercoat our Skaven with Rakarth Flesh. We'll be undercoating these miniatures in exactly the same way as the Liberators. We'll thin down our paint with fresh clean water so it's not too thick or too thin, and apply it to the models, making sure that we get into all the recesses and gaps. Then we'll leave that coat to dry and do the same thing with our 2 other Clanrats, or how many you're painting this time around. Then we can repeat the process 2 more times. Then we should have our Skaven undercoated with a smooth but solid colour. This will act as our sticking point for the rest of our colours, but actually it's the main colour for the skin and fur of the Skavens automatically. Remember to still take your time, even if you are excited and want to keep going. Patience is as important as practice when it comes to painting. Take a break if needed. It's good to refresh yourself, even when you're just getting a drink or looking at what the Skaven are on page 27. Now our furry fiends are undercoated, we can start adding base coats. Seeing that we have done a lot of base coats on our Liberators already, this will be much easier now and you'll blast through this whole step in no time. We'll use Khorne Red for a few different details, such as the cloth they wear, the banner held by the Standard Bearer, and any little tongues poking out open mouths. You can see there is a gallery of Clanrats on page 19, if you need to see where these colours go on each rat. As this paint is going over a lighter colour, you might find that the first coat dries slightly pink, rather than red. That is totally fine. By the time you apply a second coat, that dark red tone will be there and much more solid. Right, now that our red is down, we'll change our paint water quickly and move on to our next colour. Next, we'll move on to Steel Legion Drab. We'll use this on any wood found on the Skaven. This could be shields, weapon hafts and the banner pole. We'll also use this for any leather belts, pouches and straps. Just take your time as these are very small details. So if you slip and make a mistake, just wait for it to dry and then cover with Khorne Red now or when you have applied all your base coats. A few of the Clanrats have small rocks or branches they are standing on or leaping off. So we'll paint those too with this colour. Here's some I did earlier out of my set. Don't worry if you get some on the base. We'll be tidying them up later. Now we have most of our colours down, we'll focus on the metals now with Leadbelcher. We'll use this for any weapons, the musician's bell and the icon on the banner. We'll also use this for any chainmail under the cloth and the edges of the shields and any armour as well. Not every Clanrat has the same amount of detail, so check the gallery out on page 19 to see what you need to paint or tidy up. Now we have a nice solid silver. That is all but one paint done, and this next colour is only on the Claw Leader. That last detail is the Stormcast helmet the Claw Leader is standing on, and for this we'll use a couple of coats of Retributor Armour. Even though this detail is only small and on one Skaven model, it really tells a story of a battle that has been fought right now in the Age of Sigmar. And with that last paint dry, our Skaven Clanrats are now done. Repeat the steps that we just completed on the rest of your Skaven and you'll have a whole horde of Verminous Ratmen ready to fight the mighty warriors of Sigmar. But there is one small step we can add that will really make our models look like they are fighting on the same battlefield. and also tidies up any mess on those bases. Even if you have multiple colours on that base, we can cover those little smudges and brush marks with a couple of neat coats of Steel Legion Drab. We'll go around all the model's feet and any of the details such as the banner pole end and rocks. Just be careful of the other details by taking your time when you apply this colour. We want to hide mistakes, not make more, but you can always tidy up any stray marks here or there. We want to avoid getting any of this colour on the sides of the base also, as we want to keep that in a black colour. But if you do get any on there, either wipe it off while it's still wet with a bit of damp paper towel, or if it's dried on from earlier, just paint the edges of the base too. It's really up to you. Just be careful and hold the model itself if you're doing so. I'm keeping mine clean and black though. And there we are! The mighty Stormcast Eternals and the sneaky and stabby Skaven, both ready to fight over the mortal realms. Get the gaming mat out and roll those dice. Even with a few paints and a bit of time, we got all these models from grey plastic into amazingly coloured characters. You learned to master the basics. Now you can take your painting even higher by learning even more. To find out where your journey goes next, citadelcolour.com can show you the many paths you can go. We have a great playlist of painting essentials and lots of painting guides on the Warhammer YouTube channel. Or maybe you'd like to learn in person at one of our many Warhammer stores with amazing staff. Wherever your Warhammer journey goes next, it's always going to be a blast. I hope you enjoyed this video and painting your models, and we hope to see you again soon. Bye bye!